real danger to teenagers because of their obscene and sometimes violent lyrics. Here's David White.
They're attacking homosexuals, they're attacking migrants, they're attacking blacks. You know, they're just attitudes that aren't no longer acceptable in our community, really.
Lock up your daughters. Guns N' Roses are coming to town, and they welcome the description of the most dangerous band in the world.
It's the first time Guns N' Roses has performed since last week, after a riot broke out at their St. Louis concert. The crowd went berserk after the band's lead singer became angry with a fan armed with a camcorder.
This time they're under fire not for mayhem at one of their massive concerts, but for some songs their critics say preach hate and violence.
Some of their lyrics promote attitudes which to me border on neo-Nazi views, and I just think that's very unfortunate to be having those sort of views promoted to our kids.
Pauline Smith is the National Secretary of the Women's Action Alliance, and it's this sort of message she's objecting to.
Immigrants and faggots, they make no sense to me. They come to our country and think they'll do as they please. Like start some mini Iran or spread some f***ing disease.
Now, I'm not opposing the visit of Guns N' Roses to Australia. I just want it understood that they don't sing those lyrics to our young people while they're here.
I think it's got to be taken with a grain of salt. I mean, I think it's you're getting in fairly dangerous ground if it's the whole censorship issue.
Heavy metal rock journalist Murray Engelhart.
I mean, I think once an artist starts to bend and scrape to various minority groups like that, the whole artistic concept goes right out the window, and that's pretty dangerous too. What Guns N' Roses are doing is a great deal different to what the Rolling Stones were doing in the 60s, and what Elvis in his own way was doing in the 50s. I think Guns N' Roses are just a logical extension of that Stones thing, the bad boy rock and roll thing.
Well, I don't know about you, but I was a bit of an Elvis fan, but I never heard him sing that stuff. There's always something to shock that has to be put forward in our community. But this is deliberately targeted at disadvantaged and minority groups in our community.
Pauline Smith wants both the government and the Guns N' Roses tour sponsor, Coca-Cola, to step in.
Well, I don't think it necessarily has to be government intervention. I understand Coca-Cola Company is funding this concert, and I think maybe they therefore have the power to dictate to the group just what they may sing and what they may not.
Do you call it guidance or censorship?
Well, if it's censorship, well then I would support it.
It's all about it's a decadence thing, but it's a freedom of spirit thing as opposed to an evil thing.
But while the argument rages on, the fans are content to make up their own minds.
I think that they have the freedom of speech and they can play whatever they like. You don't instantly have to be influenced by it.
Basically, corruption starts with the home and your environment. I think music plays a very small part of that.
No one is ever forced to believe the lyrics that they're listening to. It's always free choice, and you either accept or reject what they say.
Guns N' Roses debate. After the break, a story that touched